And the players heading back out on the field for the second half here. Pirates versus UWA, and the score, 1-1. And vital game in early stages of the season. A place at the top of the ladder, potentially up for grabs here tonight. Both teams within striking distance if they can win tonight. UWA currently sitting in second place, and the Pirates, well, they're in fourth position. Neither side has lost a game yet. Maguire found Finlayson on the outer side. He shoots the ball through, gained territory, but couldn't retain possession. Froze. The deflection on from Edmonds. Couldn't find a teammate either. Great last few minutes of that half. They looked like they were being dominated, the Pirates, but came back, able to score the leveller. Can they go on with it now? That ball gave Edmonds a good look, but it has ended up with George. And Nettleton couldn't handle it. Back to George. Opportunity here. Can they find a way through? They can't. Pike waited for it, won it. And Edmonds, not happy with the ball that he delivered there. Is Norris now for the Pirates. Looks up forward. Didn't like what he saw. Happy to send it back to reset. A bit of a mistrap there. Has let Schubert in. It has. Schubert's won the ball. And they're on the march here. Here is Grant. Back to Boyce. Edmonds. Left it behind, and Borza, he's served his time out. He's back on the field now. Of course, he received a yellow card late stages of that first half. Froze, no real dramas clearing there. There's Schubert and Bevan, two veterans again. Been a good contest. Borza now. And they create something here. They do look dangerous. Here's Boyce. Can he get on the reverse? He can't. Defence was there. And the Pirates able to break that one up. It was Angwin with the timely tackle there on Boyce. Just when things looked like they were starting to happen for UWA. Oh, things look like they're going to happen for UWA when this man gets his stick on the ball, Schubert. Jeff Boyce. Good desperate lunge there from Angwin. Boyce. Edmonds to Boyce. Borza tried to blast it through. It will remain a UWA ball. Deflection through. There's George again. Always in the right place at the right time. Borza still fighting for it. Can he get something useful away here? He can't. A lot of Pirates came to meet him, and the Pirates won out on that occasion. Only so much Chris Borza could do there. George, level head required. Great pass through to Maguire in tight circumstances. Maguire, though, overwhelmed. wins the whistle. George, good ball through to Pearson. Pearson found his way through his opponent off the foot of Froese. Angwin now to Hayward. Hayward goes wide. That's Coates out there. Whistle goes the way of University. Here's Coates. Maguire, I should say, lost it. There's a missed trap there from Newman. Curtin players stream forward. This is Ogden. Just coughed it up. And UWA happy to send it down the other end of the field. About 7 minutes elapsed in this second half. No damage done to the scoreboard as yet. Here's George. Through to Angwin. Borza, handy ball. Gives Bunny an opportunity. Only found Curtin players. Back to George. They go all the way back to Hayward. Norris now to Rhys Angwin. George, what a great asset he is to the Pirates. Fantastic to have a player back there, you know, is very good in his position, very rarely beaten, and can also create from the back. And watched him at halftime as well, giving instruction to his players, imparting his experience onto his teammates. This is Coates now. Stick in from Boyce was good. He's won the ball. This is Jeff Boyce running the sideline. Has gained territory. Through to Michael Boyce now. Borza. Good ball out there to Schubert. Schubert runs the arc. Still going, Schubert. They can't quell him. And he's won a whistle, Grant Schubert. Got an opportunity here now, UWA. This is Ashford, took it outside the D and coughed it up. So it all breaks down. Maguire's ball. They go backwards, UWA. There's Newman. Bunny. Had support there in Edmonds. It's with the Pirates, though. Finlayson back to George. Good man to have the ball in any circumstance. George followed up, found a way through. This is that creation who's talking about. He's in the D. This is very dangerous here. Oh, mistrap there from Angwin. And Kyle tried to follow up as well. And saw our good buddy Tristan Woodhouse giving us some words of support. Thanks. Thanks, buddy. Enjoying the game here, as everyone else is here in Perth Hockey Stadium tonight between these two very good sides. Oh, on a long run here, eventually UWA shut it down. But they are pressing here, the Pirates. That was Ashford fighting as if his life depended on it back there. Lofted ball, handled by George, handled well. Good ball through to Maguire. Norris. Hayward. Angwin. Waste no time. Flirted with the idea of sending it in the D. Didn't like what he saw. Sent it back to George. George in turn goes back. Hayward to retrieve. A lot of time in control here by the Pirates. Can they convert it onto the scoreboard? Here's George. Norris. Fight for a midfield. Boyce came up with it. Nearly got tripped over. Bit of aggro there. And there's a yellow card for Angwin. Boyce certainly not happy that went on as long as it did. George was through him. It'll be a UWA ball. And that'll be a crowd killer. Potentially, no, bounced harmlessly, fortunately. And Stevenson now sweeps it to Newman. Back to Stevenson. Has Boyce, Jeff Boyce, in support. Main, he infringed there, so whistle the way of the Pirates. Maguire. He's got three to beat there, had nowhere to go. He's being forced backwards. Eventually numbers win out. Pike through to Edmonds. Oh, keeper did very well there, came off his line. Edmonds gets another opportunity, does he? No, missed. And eventually the Pirates can clear. No, they can't. Keeper again forced to do some work, but he missed it this time, and the ball eventually in the back of the net. And it wasn't pretty, but it doesn't matter how they go in, because it still all counts on the score sheet. And eventually it was Ashford, I think, that got the final touch on that one and puts UWA into the lead. They just could not clear the D on that occasion, the Pirates. And the goalkeeper was working overtime, Mark Taylor, but couldn't keep them out. And the weight of opportunities told the tale for UWA. They've taken the lead, 2-1 now.
UWA second goal, empty number five, Ben Ashford.
Maguire tried to force it through, couldn't find a way. Norris is there. It's ended with Froese. Borza now. Borza. Good ball through to Main. Good work there by Main to get round the first opponent, but George there to mop up the crumbs. And once again, Maguire has multiple opponents to beat. Did it well. No panic from him. And certainly no panic from this man. Bevan George sweeps it wide. Once again, they've conceded the lead here, the Pirates. Can they strike back? That ball has beaten everybody over the sideline. Here's Bunny. Bunny with it again. Oh, did that very well. Ashford was equal to it. Into the D. Another opportunity here for UWA. Fighting hard for it is Main. Ball beats him over the sideline, though. And they've certainly steadied the ship, UWA, although Pirates might have an opportunity here. Ball from Finlayson was deflected. This is Dane Angwin now. Sensing the danger, UWA have all players back. Dangerous deflection, no one there though. This is Pike. A little bit too much on it for Wickham. Angwin into Maguire. Always seems to have a whole bunch of players around him, Nathan Maguire, and always seems to manage to find an outlet. Here we go. Here's Schubert. Can he get a shot away? He can. Goalkeeper's there. They still haven't cleared. They have now. Danger is averted. Can they do anything on the counter here? No, they're held up. But they managed to avoid going 3-1 down there. Here's Borza. Easy one for George to deal with. Nettleton can't find his way through Froese. Froese did very well. Borza now waits. Looks up. And Wickham off his stick onto his boot. And ball to the opposition. George had plenty of time to recover here. Sweeps it forward. Very good ball. Angwin tripped. Only has UWA players ahead of him. George comes up to take this. Tries to find a way through. He does, and does well. They still haven't cleared it. They have now. Umpire helps them out. Here's Wickham. Schubert ran straight into Angwin. Searching for the leveller now are the Pirates. This is Williams now. Back to Williams. He'll wind up, send it in the D. Oh, fantastic work on the last line of defense there. That was Boyce. And he was able to deflect what should have been a goal. Cracked in. And no one there on this occasion for the Pirates. That was the leveler they needed, but they were denied. Schubert now plays on. He's off to the races. Grant Schubert gets around one opponent. Can he go all the way here? Grant Schubert, and tripped as he's in the D. And that'll be a penalty stroke to UWA. Came off the back of a storming run from Grant Schubert. He got around one opponent. And on his mind was one thing and one thing only. He was heading goalward. He won't get the opportunity. It's Sam Pike who steps up to the spot. But he certainly created that with a bursting run through the midfield. Pike with Taylor to beat. And it's wide. High and wide. So a wasted opportunity there for UWA, and Sam Pike, the man who's already scored 8 goals this season, couldn't make them pay. Exciting stuff there though from Schubert, wasn't it? Winding back the clock as he burst through the curtain defense. Unfortunately for him and his side, the result wasn't what they wanted. And Pike, normally pretty lethal in front of goals, couldn't put them away. So with just over 13 minutes left on the clock, Curtin still well and truly in this game. Was that the sealer that wasn't to be? Angwin now, here's McGuire. Haywood. We're to share it round at the back. It's back with Haywood now. We'll go wide again. Down the line with Angwin now. Dane Angwin, that is. Got around Main, couldn't get around Borza. His Coates outnumbered. Wickham pounces through to Schubert, and he is well clear. Grant Schubert gets the shot away, and once again, the goalkeeper was equal to the task, but how did he get so much space by himself? He's been doing that all night. Grant Schubert. Oh, another opportunity goes begging for UWA. Two really good chances in the last couple of minutes. And the score remains 2-1. Goalkeeper did a great job there. Schubert looked in for all money. Here's Angwin trying to force the issue down the other end of the field. is Boyce now. Boyce sends it upfield. Finlayson. Things settling down again. Here's Coates on a long run here. Oh, danger. No whistle. Eventually one comes. It goes the way of Curtin. And just like that, the Pirates have an opportunity to strike back here. Angwin was lurking in the circle by himself. If Edmonds can get on the end of this, no, he can't. It was too far in front of him. A lot of what-ifs so far for UWA. They've still got the lead though, 2-1. Boyce, that's off the foot of Dane Angwin. Borza. Wins a whistle. Where's he going to go? Blasted in the D. It's off a Curtin stick. Some more defending for the Pirates to do here. Borza, they look to spread it now. Here's Bunny. Reverse in, only found Finlayson. Eventually they shovel it forward, and that's a good ball, a very good ball through to Ogden. He couldn't trap though. And the ball beat him over the sideline. Oh, that's a missed trap here. They've let the Pirates in. Coates, can he get a shot away? Oh, great work there from Boyce again, sensing the danger. He charged Coates, came away of it. Borza, handy deflection. He'll say he meant to do that. Here's Boyce, who saved UWA on a couple of occasions here. And that would have been a very good ball, just wrong-footed Ashford. But they look dangerous on the counter, both sides in fact. End-to-end stuff, great hockey. Just haven't quite had the finish so far in this half. Here's Schubert fighting hard once again worked his way past an opponent. Had too many to beat on this occasion. Ashford with the crumbs. Bunny now. Boyce. Edmonds, too fierce for Michael Boyce. George, oh, how does he find people at range like that? Big stick check there. And there'll be a card. A yellow card it is. To Michael Boyce. My apologies. The yellow card there was to Froze. So second player they've had sent off tonight, UWA. And once again, this is where they scored in the first half when they had the numerical advantage. They've got 7 minutes on the clock to level. Possibly even score a double to claim this game. And another card there, so there's Kyle Angwin, So that levels the number of players up on the field. Less bodies in the way. Opportunity for both sides to score here. Deflection from Dane Angwin is mopped up by George. And Kyle Angwin, he's headed down the race as he knows his night is over. Ashford out to Bunny. Bunny stopped to Borza. On the overlap now is Boyce to Michael Boyce. That's off a foot. 6 minutes remaining. Can they seal the deal here, UWA? Boyce. The two Boyces combined. It's in the D. Only Pirates in the way. And disciplined defense over the sideline. Stevenson now to Newman. Here's Boyce. Rare mistrap from George. Gets it back now. Angwin on Boyce. The two tens clash. Okay, we've got a stoppage here as Dane Angwin comes off. He's got a bit of a limp. That sends Norris onto the field for the Pirates. He heads straight back because he's got some defending to do here. Jeff Boyce, there's Michael Boyce. Stevenson, they're forced all the way back to Newman. Stevenson, Rhys Angwin came at him, didn't panic. Here's Michael Boyce now. He's got Pike up ahead of him. Can he get it through to him? Just over 4 minutes remaining. Pike had it initially, still fighting for it. Yeah, gave away the free hit though. As we see Grant Schubert head back onto the field for the final moments of this game. His side leading it by a solitary goal. And the Pirates strike here. At the death to remain undefeated within this competition. That ball sent forward, and that's probably good enough for UWA at this stage. Clock is their friend. It is the enemy of the Pirates. Here's George on a long run. They let him go. They need to pull something special off here. Big dive from Borza. Missed the ball, though. Haywood, George, up forward. Ball in the D in a dangerous spot. Big fight for it there. Eventually the shot away and it's through. It's through the goalkeeper and they have equalised in the final minutes here. Haywood had an eternity there to set that up on the reverse and blasted it. The keeper was there but went straight through the legs and it's two apiece. Now with 2.5 minutes left on the clock. Is there another sting in the tail here? That was a little bit against the run of play, you'd have to suggest. And Haywood, he was a long way from home, normally camped in defense, was right there. Angwin, can he get the winner? A couple of UWA players cut the danger off. There's Boyce. What can he find? And disappointing ball from Boyce. He's done a lot of good things tonight. That wasn't one of them, fair to say. Minute 40 left. Can we get a winner here? Got two balls on the pitch. That's not good. Ball will come back. George repeats the lofted ball. Here's Boyce to Borzak. Can they steal the game here? UWA, they're pressing. Over the baseline, minute to go. In the D, big contest, important one. One by Curtin and one well. It was Norris with a great tackle on Edmonds, an important one. Here's Borza, this could be the last throw of the dice here. Boyce, can he burst his way through? He can't. Here's George again. Always seems to be there at the right time. Giving the ball to Bunny. Here's Schubert, long way from home. Here's the shoe, wheels around. And Finlayson fighting hard. There's Pike, so finding a way through. Newman, 7 seconds on the clock. They need to get in the D and get a shot away. They can't. That was great stuff by Hayward. And the man who scored the leveller has the final touch on the ball and averted any possibility of a goal being scored. And so there it ends at two apiece. Good contest between both these sides. The Pirates somehow managed to pull an equaliser out there and claim some points from this. One that got away, you suggest, for UWA. Had some great chances there. Couldn't convert, of course, had the penalty stroke. Sam Pike sent it over the bar, and Schubert as well had a very good opportunity in that second half. They always threatened to go 2-0 up. Couldn't do so, and the Pirates punished them in the final minutes there and were able to get the draw. With Bevan George, one of the veterans of the Curtin Trinity Pirates, and Bevan, fantastic contest tonight.
No, it's good. I suppose you hope, as a coach, you hope your boys put up a good performance, and that's what we were hoping for. And they're obviously the benchmark of the competition at the moment, so to get a draw out of it, I'm quite pleased considering the game, yeah.
Obviously the game waxed and waned. You guys absorbed a lot of pressure and were always able to find answers, so you must be pretty pleased with that.
Yeah, definitely. And it's probably one of the things that's been a bit of a weakness in the last couple of games, is conceded a couple of soft goals. And I think tonight, even a couple of silly mistakes, I mean, you'd like to think you'd play the perfect game as a team, but you always make those mistakes, and sometimes you get away with them, sometimes you don't. And but yeah, I think we probably in the first half we had some good momentum, we didn't get enough out of it, but the second half they probably had the better of us, and to get a 2-2 draw out of it all in the end, I'm pretty happy, yeah.
Absolutely, and your own game, you must be pretty happy, you're pretty comfortable controlling things back there.
Oh yeah, and definitely, yeah, it was probably the best game all year, so I think the way they played, I suppose, suited me a lot. So I suppose other games I haven't, and it's probably had to trouble my knee. So I've been at the best I've moved all year. So I'm pretty happy with the game. Yeah.
Good stuff. And in terms of the team, you remain undefeated, and obviously bigger and better things for the rest of the season.
Yeah, definitely. And as I said before, I was hoping for a performance tonight, and it's sort of looking at the bigger picture. So in hindsight, you know, if we probably didn't win that game, I would have thought there'd be a lot of good things to come out of it looking forward. And I like to think that we could have a chance at the finals this year, and things that we do now is sort of in preparation for things that, yeah, we can hopefully pull everything together in the finals and maybe knock off a few of the big boys.
All right, good stuff. Congratulations.
Thanks, mate.